Better late than never. 2019 was a crazy busy year for me, so I didn't get through many games. In 2019, I only managed to play 52. That doesn't mean I didn't play some great games though. These are my top 20 games I played in 2019. Number 20, Pwned. Pwned has a Metacritic score of 76. I gave it a 7. My girlfriend and I haven't really got a chance to sit down and play games together with our busy life. Pwned changed this for us. This is a co-op based puzzle game where you play as a rock and a star, overcoming obstacles together, and it's adorable. One of my most favorite puzzle games I've played in a while. Number 19, Die Young. Die Young has a Metacritic score of 7. I gave it a 6.5. I have a love-hate relationship with Die Young. The mission structure here is awful and forces constant backtracking with its endless dead-end quests. And by endless, I mean literally all of them are dead-end quests. However, if you look past this is one of the most well-crafted and intriguing worlds to explore of the year, and hopefully in 2020, maybe we'll see this title hit consoles. Number 18, Effie. Effie has a Metacritic score of 68. I gave it a 6. Simple and plain, Effie is baby's first Jack and Daxter game. It's cute, colorful, easy. While there isn't anything special here, this is a pretty okay 3D platformer nostalgia trip. Number 17, Layers of Fear 2. Layers of Fear 2 has a Metacritic score of 70. I gave it a 6. This one hurt. I love Bloober Team. The original Layers of Fear is one of my favorite horror games of all time, and I feel my expectations soured my experience of Layers of Fear 2. That being said, it's still Bloober Team. They have that magic that's still here. As disappointed as I was, I still enjoyed my time exploring this creepy shit. Number 16, Devil's Hunt. Devil's Hunt has a Metacritic score of 47. I gave it a 6. Devil's Hunt isn't that bad. Sure, this is more of a walking simulator than it is a Devil May Cry game, and sure, the story in this narrative-based game is awful, but Devil's Hunt definitely gets more hate than it deserves. This is a corny, cringy at times, relaxing stroll through hell, and I don't feel like I really need to say anything more. Number 15, Woven. Woven has a Metacritic score of 63. I gave it a 7. Collecting patterns, solving Banjo-Kazooie-like problems, easily the cutest game of the year for me. Such a fresh and charming experience. If Sony did what Sticky Lock Studio did here but with Little Big Planet, look out Nintendo. Woven is such a brilliant concept. Number 14, Untitled Goose Game. Untitled Goose Game has a Metacritic score of 81. I gave it a 7.5. You play as a goose creating mayhem. Next. Number 13, Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz HD. Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz HD has a Metacritic score of 70. I gave it a 7.5. I've never played a Monkey Ball game before, so this was such a fresh and fun experience for me. The frustrating thing with Monkey Ball, however, is how luck-based it feels with such a slippery ball. Some fine tunes on the friction and ooh girl look out, game of the year contender. Number 12, Paper Dolls Original. Paper Dolls Original has a Metacritic score of 65. I gave it a 6.5. This is hands down the creepiest game I played all year. You're playing in first person, either in VR or non-VR, as a father searching an abandoned house for your daughter. Crazy ghost shit happens, your heart races for 2 hours, you cry the whole time, it's really fun. Number 11, Darksiders Genesis. Darksiders Genesis has a Metacritic score of 78. I gave it an 8. Darksiders Genesis is a prequel to the Darksiders series. And aside from too many puzzles breaking the flow, this game is a blast. Slaying through enemies as War and Strife, upgrading your character, creating new strategies guaranteed to be on 2020 lists, as this game is now available for consoles. And on to the top 10. Number 10, Greedfall. Greedfall has a Metacritic score of 78. I gave it a 7. I'm surprised how much I ended up loving this game. Greedfall starts out slow, but pulls you in with its mix of Witcher and Dragon Quest gameplay. Greedfall feels very bare bones compared to those games, but is still strangely just as addictive. Number 9, Cat Quest 2. Cat Quest 2 has a Metacritic score of 78. I gave it an 8. Cat Quest 2 is a co-op top-down hack and slash dungeon crawler game where you try and bring the balance between the kingdoms of cats and dogs. Though this game does get repetitive towards the end, this grind and want to become stronger and better will push you through this addictive adventure. Number 8, Costume Quest. Costume Quest has a Metacritic score of 77. I gave it a 7.5. I did it. I finally played Costume Quest. Costume Quest is a combination of my favorite things as a child: Power Rangers, Pokemon, and Trick or Treat Beat. I love everything about Costume Quest, and I'm so happy I finally got around to playing it. Number 7, Team Sonic Racing. Team Sonic Racing has a Metacritic score of 73. I gave it a 7. Sorry, Crash Team Racing, this is my kart racer of the year. Sonic Racing games just have something special about them, and Team Sonic Racing continues this with its added layer of strategy to racing with its team mechanics. This is no way as good as All-Stars Racing Transform, but Team Sonic Racing offers a solid racing experience worth any kart racing fan's time. Number 6, Medieval. Medieval has a Metacritic score of 67. I gave it an 8. Medieval is a remake of the original game with the same name, and it's such a charming yet difficult journey to go through. Everyone can call Medieval easy all they want, but they're scared of the truth. This is the original Dark Souls. Fight me. Number 5, Control. Control has a Metacritic score of 85. I gave it an 8. Control is one of the biggest surprises of 2019. It came out of nowhere in this fairly weak year of games. Though to be fair, I haven't played Shadows Die Twice, Pokemon, Kingdom Hearts 3, or Outer Worlds yet. This is a sleeper hit, a sci-fi division type game that mixes government and conspiracy. If you haven't played Control yet, stop right now and download it. Number 4, Peggle Blast. Peggle Blast has a Metacritic score of 52. I didn't review it, but if I did, I would have gave Peggle Blast a 7.5. Like I said at the beginning of this video, life got in the way of gaming this year, which led me to doing the unthinkable, playing a mobile game during my 72-hour journey to spend my anniversary with my girlfriend in Bali. We would compete against each other, seeing who could get further, getting frustrated at the stupid life system, but, and there is a but, what saved this game for me was a little hack. You can close the app and not lose a life, essentially turning this into a proper Peggle game. Play as much as you need. Levels should be challenging, not life-draining. Number 3, Resident Evil 2 Remake. The remake of Resident Evil 2 has a Metacritic score of 93. I gave it an 8.5. Hands down, best action game to come out of 2019. If it ain't broke, paint over it with futuristic graphics is what I always say. As someone that really got into gaming within the past 10 years, I love the trend of modernizing classics. This is a trend I'm ready to see continue into the next generation of consoles. And much like me, if you never got a chance to play Resident Evil 2 in any of its forms, now's your chance. Much like Control, this is a 2019 must play. Number 2, A Plague Tale Innocence. A Plague Tale Innocence has a Metacritic score of 83. I gave it a 7. Technically, this is my 2019 game of the year if I only counted games that came out in 2019 instead of counting literally anything I played to completion. More than Control, more than Resident Evil 2, I love Plague Tale Innocence. This is the hidden gem under the radar game of the year. This is an action stealth game where you play as an older sister caring for and protecting her little brother during the time of the plague. The gameplay is mostly stealth-based puzzles, but the power here is in the story. A Plague Tale Innocence will keep you hooked from start to finish. And number 1, my favorite game, and notice, I said favorite, not best. I don't rank this list based off of the scores I give, I base it off of my personal enjoyment. My 2019 game of the year. I can't believe this. Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Assassin's Creed Odyssey has a Metacritic score of 87. I gave it a 7.5. Alas, here we are, my favorite game I played in 2019. It says a lot that it's a game I made a 15-minute long rant for my review of how it would have been lucky to be in my top 10 of 2018. It says 2019 was a pretty weak year for games, and also that I'm an Assassin's Creed fanboy. Both of these things are true, not to take away from the games in this list. But if I had to combine 2018's list with 2019, I don't see anything out of my top 5 making last year's list. But I love Assassin's Creed, it's my favorite series. I'm vastly disappointed in the quality of Odyssey in terms of Assassin's Creed goes, but as a game by itself without the words Assassin's Creed attached to it, this is a really good game all about collecting, a collectathon map cleaner. Fingers crossed in the future though, Ubisoft goes back to what made Assassin's Creed so special in the first place. Not just its time traveling, but its conspiracy, its narrative. But thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know your favorite games you played in 2019. Again, I didn't get to play everything I wanted to. I didn't get to play the new Jedi game, Pokemon, Kingdom Hearts. I didn't get to Borderlands 3 or The Division 2. There's a lot of games I want to go back and play, and possibly they'll make my 2020 list. But we'll see. Let me know what are some must-play games that didn't make this list that I should go back and play this year. But thanks for watching. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Follow me on Instagram at SuperKenGaming, and of course, stay beautiful. If you like this video, please consider supporting me on Patreon so that I can continue to bring you reviews for all the newest games at patreon.com/superkengaming. You'll get access to early audio and video versions of reviews, exclusive Let's Play videos, and you'll even get to choose the game I play next. Thanks for watching, and of course, stay beautiful.